Look what Comey conveniently deleted that could be the end of him. Former FBI Director James Comey deleted a memo that could have been important during his first testimony since being fired by President Trump. The memo is reportedly something he potentially leaked to the New York Times. Comey reported that he deleted it. This is also known as the "I'm not giving you anything that may or may not harm me" strategy, where people usually refuse to deliver something that may harm them in any way. Is it an admission of guilt, or did Comey simply delete the leaked memo because it had nothing of importance? But that drives us to ask that if it wasn't important, then why leak it? If it wasn't him, or it didn't contain damning information, then why not produce a copy of it? How did Comey send it? Email. Snail mail. Hand delivery. Carrier pigeon. If email, then there's a copy in his sent email folder. Or maybe there's an old draft. If not, then there's probably a way to roll back his computer to a previous date and see a copy of it there. The thing with computers is that things deleted are usually recoverable. Even the Geek Squad idiots at Best Buy can sometimes figure that out for a ridiculously overpriced fee. After former FBI Director James Comey testified on Thursday, the Senate Intelligence Committee naturally asked Comey for a copy of the infamous memo in question that he had leaked through a friend to the New York Times. During testimony, Comey testified he felt he needed to take notes to protect himself in his conversations with President Donald Trump, and then being so concerned about going on record with facts after a Trump tweet that he supposedly had his friend, Daniel Richman, leak the contents to the New York Times. Problem. When the committee asked for the memo, Comey said he no longer had copies. So where is it, bro? You mean to tell me in 2017, with the crazy amount of advanced technology, that there's no way to recover a copy of a memo? Is this the only guy who handwrites memos and faxes them like it's the late 80s? I didn't know James Comey served as a 6-foot grade school secretary in his spare time. Maybe he has another career after all. I'm guessing either Comey is playing hardball and doesn't care to provide a memo because he thinks it's pointless, or the slight chance that he doesn't want them to see it. The committee was then required to request copies from the Richman. Here's the relevant excerpt of the letter to Richman noting this. So this was so important for Comey to take the notes to protect himself, but then he deleted the memo from his FBI laptop. As we have previously reported, the New York Times reporter who broke the story never even saw the memo. Indeed, the information he got from Richman was recounted to him over the phone from what Richman supposedly remembered. Richman didn't have the memo when he spoke to the reporter. So would he even be able to turn it over to the committee now if he didn't have it then? What in the sweet Jesus is going on here? Comey has a memo but deletes it, but there's a leak, but he protects himself, but what next? This sounds more and more like a TV drama about government. I swear it's like we've watched this on television before. If people really want to get a memo from a computer, then it probably only takes a few moments. However, it's an FBI computer. Maybe they have a self-destruct option like Inspector Gadget's notes that Chief Quimby reads from the safety of a trash can. Sounds more and more like Chief Quimby is the inspiration for this memo that apparently self-destructed. So what's next? The testimony ticked Trump into a tweet storm. The public is half confused and half doesn't even care anymore. Comey is probably looking for a new job while getting his overly tall suits hemmed. 3 weeks from now, no one will care about any of this. I'm starting to believe politics is really a poorly scripted reality show, with horrible characters, on MTV, kinda like Teen Mom. Our political system has turned into a horrible group of overdramatic teen moms in high school.
Please do not forget like on videos, and subscribe, and comment because your voice matters, and visit our page on Facebook, and like them, and follow up. And thanks for watching.